I'm from Buffalo, New York. My name is Neelum Rana. I have three kids who are in school right now, and I've been in Buffalo for 15 years. I wasn't expecting what happened once you get there. You hear so many stories from everybody as to this is going, you're going to feel this or you're going to feel that. But I was telling everyone, once you come back, it's hard to put into words the feelings that you get once you're there. It was an amazing experience. Hajj is basically when you get to Mina, and those 4 days, and you put on your ihram. You have to, the ihram kind of restricts you with everything. You can't put any scented things on yourself. You can't cut your nails. You can't do anything else. And you can't say anything bad or get mad or everything. So it's not just your physical, it's your spiritual. And then, so from Mina, what you get to Mina, and then from there you go to Arafat. Whoever is in Arafat has done Hajj. The rest is all the rituals that you have to complete, but you can complete that at any time. But you have to be on the day of Arafat, which is the 9th of Zilhajj. You have to be in Arafat. If you're not there, you haven't done your Hajj. And it is hard. I wouldn't say that it's easy. I don't know, you don't get tired, you're not sleeping, you're not eating enough because you're not at home, you're in a camp. Because Mina is basically all camps. It's not like a hotels. They're all camps. They want you to experience that camp feeling because that's how Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did it. And so they don't make it like a permit. They can. The Saudi government can make everything permanent, but they don't. You enjoy it. I mean, I was telling, but I think the younger the better. The younger the better. I saw people who were in their wheelchairs and very old, and we would be like, you know, that's their commitment, they're doing it. But I was telling everybody that if you go at a certain age, the hardships become fun. You know, you're standing for 5 hours, but you're in a group of friends, and you kind of, it's not like, it's not killing yourself, you're enjoying it. You're enjoying it even though it's hard, but it kind of, the hardships become fun. So that's what I felt. And the amount of patience I saw in people with the, you know, you're waiting and you're tired and everybody's exhausted. But I never saw anybody get like angry or, you know, impatient, you know, because you know you're there for Hajj and, you know, it's part of it.